Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Today we're going to see how we handle performance appraisals in Odoo. It's important to let our employees know how they're doing, set goals for them, and keep track of their progress. This helps them grow and become better employees. Their company may even reward their growth with a promotion or maybe a bonus. So let's dive into our database to see how the Odoo Appraisals app helps everyone successfully achieve their goals. Let's kick things off on the appraisal dashboard. Here, I can see all of my employees, their job titles, and their various appraisal statuses. We can click on the list view on the top right for a simplified layout of each person's status. Now let's take a look at some important settings. For that, we'll go to the configuration subheading and click on settings. Under the feedback template section here at the top, I can make changes to the employee and manager templates, which are used to gather an employee's self-evaluation, as well as their manager's feedback. Under the employee feedback template, I can click on an open area and start typing a new question. I'm going to go under my work section and add, what are my goals for next year? And then I'm going to go ahead and save this. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and scroll to the bottom to the appraisal section. Here in appraisal plans, I can set the time frame for when our appraisals should be conducted. Our current setup has an appraisal automatically created for 6 months after an employee's contract start date, 6 months after that, and then 12 months after that. This is completely customizable in Odoo, but I like these timeframes, so we're gonna keep it as is. You should note that the number of appraisals an employee can request through Odoo depends on the minimum time between appraisals configured here. So be sure to keep that in mind as you configure these settings for your company. Alrighty, on the right of the appraisal plans, you'll see the 360 feedback feature, which uses the survey app to request feedback from other team members or from an employee other than a manager at any point during the appraisal process. When we click on the internal link icon next to the default template field, we see a number of survey options. These are fully customizable from the questions, the format options, descriptions, and end message. For more information on creating surveys, check out our tutorials on the Surveys app. Now let's check out our evaluation scale. Let's go to the configuration subheading and hit evaluation scale. Here, I can set up scales for our appraisals, which will show up as a drop-down menu on the appraisal form. Let's click New and create a new category called Superstar Employee. Awesome. Okay, now that all of our settings are configured, let's go ahead and create an appraisal by hitting the appraisal subheading at the top, and let's click New and choose our employee, Audrey Peterson. Notice the manager field and appraisal date autofill. The appraisal date field represents the deadline, which is automatically set to a month from today's date. Okay, let's hit confirm. Let's say I'm Audrey's manager, and as her manager, I can give feedback by clicking into the manager's feedback section and fill it out. Audrey did a great job, so I'm gonna let her know. I can also select the star ratings to show how well she's doing. Let's put a 5 for time management. When I'm finished, I can move this toggle at the top of the feedback form to make it visible to the employee. Once it's published, this information will still remain confidential. Only Audrey, her manager, and people with proper access rights will be able to see this. Other employees will not. At the top of the page, we can click the employee's Goal Smart button. Let's create some new goals for them to accomplish by clicking New. Audrey can add her own goals when she's filling out her appraisal, but we can create them for her as well. Let's say that Audrey's goal is to lead a training. I recently learned that she's been preparing for an upcoming training session, so let's update her progress to 50%. In the deadline field, let's set her presentation date to a week from today. Hopefully, this motivates her to do even better. Alrighty, let's go to Audrey's appraisal via the breadcrumbs. Now, as part of the appraisal process, we also want to evaluate our employees' skills development. We can do that from the Skills tab in the appraisal form. As we can see, the system automatically pulled a list from Audrey's skills and current level of expertise from the employees application. Since I know that Audrey has put in a lot of effort into her professional development over the past few months, we can update her skill level. Let's click into CSM and a pop-up window will appear. Let's change the skill level to 2 and let's go ahead and save this. We can also create new skills directly from the appraisal. I know that Audrey has started taking Python training course, so I'm gonna add that as a skill. So in the programming languages line, let's click add. And for the skill, let's put Python. And for the skill level, let's say beginner. Awesome, let's save and close this. Once the appraisal is done, Audrey's skills will automatically update in the employees app as well, since Odoo's apps are all integrated. Now that we've given Audrey some feedback, we can set up a meeting to review her appraisal with her. Let's go to the No Meeting Smart button here at the top, and let's go ahead and choose a time. I think I want to do tomorrow at 10 a.m. Okay, let's go ahead and save and close this. When I head back to Audrey's appraisal via the breadcrumbs, we can see that the meeting date now appears on the Smart button and in the chatter. Awesome. Okay. Now let's say we've had the meeting and it went really well. As the manager, I also want to leave a private note. This will only be seen by other managers, not the employee. So let's go to the private note tab and type in great team player. Alrighty, for the final rating near the top of the form, I'll choose superstar employee from my evaluation scale because Audrey is doing a fantastic job. Then we can confirm the appraisal and mark it as all done in the chatter. Awesome. If we navigate back to the appraisals dashboard via the breadcrumbs, we can see that Audrey's appraisal is now marked as done. Now, do you want to see a cool trick, Odooers? We can also view and conduct appraisals through the Odoo Employees app. So let's click on Audrey Peterson's employee card. We can see her last appraisal in the Smart button at the top without being in the Appraisals app. We can also see someone who is ready for an appraisal based on the 6th and 12th timeline that we set up in the Configurations menu. Let's click on the breadcrumbs to go back to the Employee Dashboard and click on Abigail Peterson. Here we can see the Request Appraisal button at the top, and we can do everything that we did in the Appraisals application right from the Employees app. Well, that's all for this lesson. See you in the next time, Odooers. Thanks for watching, and now go grab a snack.